Hello and welcome to another Giant Slayer TFT How to Play video. Today our analysts will be diving into how to play Jhin Sniper for patch 12.1. The meta has changed, but what hasn't changed is the consistency of the Jhin carry comp. For now, it's been one of the strongest builds in the meta, so of course, we're going to do a how to play for it. We'll be covering core champions, traits, items, as well as augments. Following that, we'll do a brief breakdown of each stage of the game with a few potential pivots in case Jhin refuses to show up in your game. With all that said, let's go ahead and get started. But before we begin, please don't forget to click the links in our description. Give your support to everyone who helped make this video happen. We host many TFT tournaments with plenty of exciting content to come. Be sure to also follow our Giant Slayer TFT social media pages. Alright, let's get back to the video. To start off, let's dive right into the composition, beginning with the core champions and traits. Let's get the obvious out of the way. This composition is all about Jhin and protecting Jhin so that he can pew pew from his gun and melt away the enemy team. That's a basic rundown of what a Jhin carry composition is meant to do. Buy time for Jhin. There are a few ways to accomplish this, but in general, the idea is some type of heavy frontline with lots of CC and sustain to back them up. The two most common frontlines will either be bodyguards or Colossus, sometimes a mix of both. For bodyguards, the core champion is going to always be Braum because he's both tanky and provides good CC. Colossus, the best champion, is Sion for the same reasons as Braum. You may be thinking, what about Galio? Galio is alright in addition to Sion, but as it turns out, you really don't want your main frontliner leaving the fight briefly, as is the case of Galio. Back to Braum. Leona is the natural pairing for Braum for adding sustain in frontline, while Blitzcrank opens up the door for playing both Sion and Braum. As for Sion, a good second Colossus can always be good if you have armor plating, but taking up 4 slots on your board for just 2 champions can be restricting. Generally, the best option is just Blitzcrank or another protector to pair with Sion. We'll talk about a few variations of this soon, but let's get the rest of the comp figured out. Alongside Jhin as a core champion, you almost always are going to have Orianna for clockwork and a setup for Enchanter. Plus, Orianna was buffed slightly, so she's even better than before. And finally, Misfortune rounds out the core build to provide Sniper and a bit of healing reduction with extra damage. Now is where we can delve into several variations of this comp. Most of the time, the most common extra champions will be Janna, Yuumi, and more frontline. Socialite is also playable, but not necessary, more or less it's common due to Taric. A standard level 8 board for Jhin will be Jhin, Orianna, Misfortune, Braum, Leona, Janna, Yuumi, and really anything additional you may want, like Taric or even Jace. Sion variation just tosses in Sion with Blitzcrank instead of Braum and Leona. Other variations include 4 bodyguard, particularly when an augment or emblem provides +1 bodyguard, or 4 sniper, which is similar to 4 bodyguard with the sniper emblem ideally going onto Orianna. There's plenty of other ways to mix and match this composition, but again, the theme should always center around Jhin as the main carry, with a strong frontline, lots of CC, and extra sustain. Let's now move on to the next section, which is core items. As usual, the main carry, Jhin in this case, is the one that you want to prioritize items for. But it's also equally as important to have 1 or 2 frontline items because you need that frontline to survive as long as possible. Try to aim for at least 2 Jhin items by the time you're pivoting into him, and at least 1, preferably 2 frontline items. The absolute best in slot item for Jhin is going to be Last Whisper to help him deal with heavy armored frontlines and add a nice chunk of damage with the armor reduction. While Infinity Edge may seem like the most obvious second item to grab, it's actually better to go for Giant Slayer to deal with the multitude of frontline champions that have a lot of health. It's certainly playable without Giant Slayer, but if you have the option between IE and Giant Slayer, generally always go with Giant Slayer. A last resort damage item can be Deathblade, but it's not that great compared to the other options. Or the third item, defensive or utility, is ideal, such as Quicksilver, Guardian Angel, or even Runin's Hurricane. Extra damage can be alright, but not necessary. Switching over to frontline items, really any standard defensive item is fine, such as Bramble Vest, Redemption, Warmogs, or Dragon's Claw. Bramble Vest is the best all around, since there are a lot of crit-heavy compositions in the current meta. Beyond that, Morella Namakon is an all-around solid item choice for either Orianna or Yuumi. Shojin is also quite good for Orianna, as having her cast more often equates to more CC and sustain. Finally, emblems. Sniper emblem is alright since it's strong on Orianna, but anything that helps your frontline is generally preferable. Overall, emblems aren't necessary for this comp to succeed, so only take them if presented with the option, such as with augments or a trait of times. With that, we can begin going over the various augments that are useful for this composition. Keep in mind that the first augment on 1-4 should rarely ever be tailored to a specific composition unless you're intent on forcing it regardless of how the game plays out. This is because you won't really know what you end up playing until the mid-game around level 7. For example, if you take Sniper's Nest on 1-4, you may never end up seeing a single Jhin later on. Can you still play Sniper? Possibly, but it's still a bit of a risk. So when it comes to the augments of the early game, standard generic ones are the best for helping either win streak, gain some type of economic advantage, or just generic augments that can be useful in any comp. The best options usually end up being gold to boost your early economy, more efficient rolling such as trade sector or golden ticket, or anything that increases how quickly you can level, such as clear mind or level up. Then there's options like item grad bag to gain a slight advantage with a free item or other similar augments. Emblems, hearts, and soul augments are a bit risky, though some are worth taking because they're either a free unit or extra gold. Those options tend to come down to personal preference. Once it reaches the stage 3-3 augment, then you can make more committed decisions. A lot of the themes of the 1-4 augments still apply, but now you can begin looking for djinn-specific augments like Broken Stopwatch or Sniper's Nest. Emblems and those type of augments can provide an immediate boost to your board while still helping you later on. And any generic buffs like Celestial, Cybernetic, or Weak Spot can be great options at this point of the game, since they're just all around going to help your board be stronger. Finally, on the 4-6 augment, there's really no best option, but stay away from golden experience focused augments unless you really need them. Instead, pick up anything that directly benefits your board, as by this point of the game, you should have your composition mostly figured out. Extra items or components, emblems, generic utility buffs, all of those types of augments are fantastic. Overall, there's no specific way to go about picking augments for a djinn composition, as the only two that are niche to the build are Broken Stopwatch and Sniper's Nest. Everything else is fair game depending on the state of your board and the lobby. Alright, now that we've covered champions, traits, items, and augments, we can get into a brief look at what to aim for during each stage of the game, starting with the early game. On the opening carousel, the component priority should either be a bow or glove, since those two items are used for the bulk of what you want on djinn. Giant Slayer, Last Whisper, and Infinity Edge are going to be used by a lot of champions, so having the components for them is useful in case you need to pivot. Otherwise, grab a sword, chain vest, or belt. It's fine to slam an early item, but defensive items are usually best since they can be used in practically any comp. Moving into stage 1, just look for pairs and try to build a strong board, as win streaking is the best way to transition into the mid game. Stage 2 is most of the same. Push to level 4 early to try to win unless your board is ultra weak. In that case, don't level and try to maintain a loss streak. The only benefit to doing this, besides a slightly better economy, is having priority on carousels. Keep in mind, if you're on a loss streak in stage 2, you will likely need to roll on level 6 in stage 3 to stabilize, as you don't want to go into stage 4 and beyond with less than 50 health. All in all, the early game goal is to play standard and ideally aim to win streak. Now, we can move into the mid game with stage 3. Level to 6 on either 3-1 or 3-2, and only roll if your board is looking weaker than the rest of the lobby. Also, find a wait until 3-3 to roll, as augment you get may be enough to stabilize your board. If you're not weak, then great. You can mostly skip past stage 3. That takes us to level 7 and stage 4, where usually you want to roll a bit of gold. The goal here is to look for any relevant 4 costs, which the djinn composition has quite a few of. But since it is a rather expensive composition, you can always fill your board with upgraded lower cost champions, stabilize, and aim for a faster level 8. Speaking of level 8, the earliest you're going to want to be leveling is on 4-2 if you've had a really good economy up to that point and you've been win streaking like crazy. Rule of thumb is if you can level and still have about 30 gold to roll, then level. Otherwise, the standard leveling time at level 8 will be somewhere between 4-5 and after Raptors. And finally, the late game. The goal going into stage 5 and beyond is simple. Put your composition together and upgrade your units. Ideally, you want to be able to, at minimum, hit Djinn 2, Orianna 2, and have a frontliner level 2 throughout stage 5. If not, you may end up bleeding a lot of health, so it's quite important to have a solid early and mid game leading up to that point. Once you've upgraded the important champions, you're either going to be too poor to do much with your gold, or you'll have enough economy to begin working towards level 9. Level 9, you can add an extra enchanter, more frontline, Galio if you're running Scion, or Jace for extra damage. There's no major boost in power at level 9, but it does make 2-starring 5 cost units easier. Besides that, the most important part of the late game is positioning. Always keep your djinn away from being grabbed by a Blitzcrank unless you have a Quicksilver. Avoid being in the line of fire of a Scion stun if possible, and try to position djinn on the side where his ability will pierce through the front line and into the back line. There's quite a bit of nuance to this, so the best way to learn is either playing the composition a lot or watching streams. To end with, let's go over a few potential pivots in case djinn remains elusive in your shop. As mentioned earlier, the items for djinn are fairly generic for any AD board. That means you can easily pivot into Yone, Fiora, Urgot, Jace, or any other type of AD champion. Yone, Urgot, and Fiora are the easiest because pieces of the existing composition can be used on those boards as well. As for when to pivot, it really depends on the state of your lobby, your economy, and your current board. Sometimes you can greed out and wait for Djinn 2, other times when you're desperately rolling and not hitting, you should instead pivot into whatever a 4-cost carry you're able to hit. It's all situational, but don't worry. Thanks to the items being flexible, you can easily pivot this composition, so learn to be comfortable making that decision. Outside of AD builds, well, it's mostly item dependent. Orianna is a viable carry if you're not hitting Jhin, but if you don't have at least Shoujin and an AP item for Orianna, it may not be the best idea. Augments can also dictate where you go, such as All for One with Imperial, where you can pivot into Samira carry with Sion frontline, or On Guard, opening up the door for challengers. In general though, by the time you may need to pivot, the most likely option will be some type of AD board. Luckily, there's plenty of them in the current meta to play. That's it for today's video, folks. As far as consistent compositions are concerned, Jhin is the way to go. The major downside is that it is a rather expensive composition, but that does mean it has a high cap, so the chances of placing in the top 2 are decent. The other added benefit of running Jhin Sniper is how easy it is to pivot into another composition, so it's great for learning how to play more flexibly. Let us know in the comment section below which composition you'd like us to cover in our next How to Play video. Thank you for watching, and if you're enjoying our content, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe for future Giant Slayer TFT videos.